the Thessalonian thanksgiving. Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. God of all, I praise you that in your presence is fullness of joy, that the lines of communication between us are always open. Right here, right now, I give you thanks for all by faith. I trust you in every circumstance in my life with sincere gratitude. Your holiday stress buster. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again. Rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard you as your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. O God of peace, I stop right now to give you thanks, not just because you deserve it, but because I need it. As I bring my specific requests into you now, fill my mind with the long, long list of things, big and small, that are your perfect gifts to me. Above all, thank you for your Son, for what he did for me, and that I am in him. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Your antidote of for sin. Father of forgiveness, I thank you for Jesus' sacrifice for my sin. Your promise that when I am tempted, you will provide a way out. Replace the lust and greed of my heart with overflowing praise and thanksgiving for all things you have given, especially the personal sacrifice of Jesus for me. Do this again and again, each time temptation comes my way. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Quick reminder. Quick reminder, the world is weary, and it may be hard to focus on the one we are celebrating this Christmas. That's why we have put together to help remind you that there is still a reason to celebrate this Christmas. But December is just days away, which is why we want to make sure to celebrate Advent, the message of Jesus, and experience life. Amen. Give thanks today. So then, just as you received Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live your lives in him, rooted and built up in him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thanks, thankfulness. My prayers for all of us today echo the words of these men. May those of us who have received him continue to live our lives in him, offering up the credit justly due to him for each singular deliverance and blessing, with humble patience and overflowing thankfulness. I will just let you pray this one through on your own, okay? My God and my provider, from the deep of my heart, I thank you for. Amen. Thank, be grateful together. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that The Lord is a God. It is He who made us, and we are His. We are His people, the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gate with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name. For the Lord is good and His love endures forever. Faithfulness continue through all generations. God is good. As we journey together this holiday season, we pray more and more that you and your loved ones will experience the abundant life found only in His Son, Jesus. Happy Thanksgiving. The unpopular truth. Jesus often warned those around him. As in this unnerving story he told, there was a rich man who was dressed in a purple and fine linen and lived in luxury every day. At his gate was laid a beggar named Lazarus. The time came when the beggar died, and the angels carried him to Abraham's side. The rich man also died and was buried in hell. In hell, where he was in torment, he looks up and saw Abraham far away with Lazarus by his side. So he called to him, "Father Abraham, have pity on me and send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, because I am in agony in this life." But Abraham replied, "Son, remember that in your lifetime you receive your good things, while Lazarus received bad things, but now he is comforted here and you are agony. And besides all this, between us and you a great chasm has been fixed, so that those who want to go from here to you cannot, nor can any one else from there to us." There are many lessons to be learned from this passage, but the glaring message is this: there is a heaven, there is a hell, and after death it is impossible to move from one to the other. An eternal barrier is fixed between these two places, and the decision we make on earth will determine where we spend eternity. Beloved Lord Jesus, thank you for the clarity of our word. Thank you for telling us the truth. Today and in the days ahead, give us grace and mercy and wisdom as we contemplate the eternal future of ourselves and those around us. Amen. Heavenly minded and the earthly good. Since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with Him in glory. Beloved Jesus, focus my thoughts on things above and not on earthly things. May the hope of expectation of heaven and the fact that my life is hidden with you in God right now direct my mind, my will, and my emotions today. Amen. The truth about heaven and hell. For God so loved the world that He gave us His one hand only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. Holy Spirit, through my words and my actions, live through me in such a way that those around me sense the eternal danger of hell and recognize the incredible gift of your eternal life. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Hallelujah. Amen.